Turn left onto Ingersoll Avenue, then turn right onto South 4th Street.
thank you, G. Good morning, all. We're heading off finally to take a look at the Coquille Riverwalk. So we'll get some views along the way, I guess, and see what the walk is like. It should be good. As far as I know, a lot of it is new.
Left onto Johnson Avenue.
I think they completed it either in 2021 or last year.
Yeah, I think so. But it looks fantastic from what I've seen online. It's not a trail as such, you know, like you're not up in the woods or anything, but it should be still a nice walk.
Today I will get to make Yeah, I don't know exactly where it begins, but I can ask because there is a
feet. Your destination will be on the right.
There's a camp thing there, so.
Alright guys, see you on the trail.
Well, we are now definitely in the right place.
Yep.
There we are.
Cape Tides poster and future plans on the GP site. So I wonder if it...
They're expanding it, I think, constantly, so...
Well...
King Tides. Now
this poster only goes up to 2012.
Yeah, you got to be careful with the tides out here. There's plenty of information there. Recreation River Shop. Okay, River. Cool. Well, it's nicely done up. It's been done kind of recently enough.
For bonsai. Fantastic for shade though.
Nice little picnic area down there. It's lovely. Nice and kind of shaded too. Do we know how long this walk is?
I think it's about a half a mile. One way.
Okay. It's about a mile overall.
And most of these trees above us are spruce trees.
Yeah. It is a very nice area. It is so warm. Guys, it's unbelievable.
Very warm.
Yeah. That's nice, like. So, now that we actually know where those pedal car rail line tour is, that's definitely one we're going to be doing as well. We've actually been looking at that for a couple of years. And I think that would be a lot of fun.
It's about a 2-hour run trip. We should do it this year.
Yeah.
No telling when the railroads are going to expand and cut off their access again.
Yeah.
Because you can't do that on an active railway.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's really, really nice along here.
I can see as Coquille expands that this becomes a major place to come and be and recreate.
Yeah. Oh yeah, it'd be lovely.
River right here.
Yeah, that looks halfway. Path that goes right down, because there's the river right there. I'm not sure if you guys can see it. But you can see it there, it's lovely.
I don't know what the rules are concerning the river itself.
Well, fishing and stuff?
No, I mean like swimming and touching the river.
Yeah.
Each city has their own particular rules about it.
Yeah. Oh, look at that out there. That's just gorgeous.
Lots of, cows.
Yeah.
Beef, milk, or mac and cheese.
Huh?
Either beef, milk, or mac and cheese.
Beef, milk, what do you mean?
The cows.
Oh. Yeah, there's a river right there. That's good. I think I saw like there's a kind of a wooden part to this as well, I think, isn't there? I thought I saw something on Facebook about it.
I'm not sure.
Like we're literally going right along the river there. Oh, there we go.
The birds around here are white-crowned sparrows and song sparrows.
What's the name of that app again?
Merlin.
Merlin, yeah. You want to identify birds in your area? Install the app. Merlin. Yeah, they're very quiet. We see them down by the bay from time to time.
Hey, this is
Yeah.
Have not proceeded any further.
Yeah, this is as far as they've got so far, but that is a nice start. Might be able to go around with there, but I don't think so. And that looks like where it's going to continue on.
Hopefully.
Yeah, because you can see that loops back around to the river.
Because we definitely have to respect the signs.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. So that's nice to head back around.
Sure, but I see a lot of potential for this walk.
Oh, huge potential. Because it is beautiful, as you can see there, we're going right along by the river. Yeah, it is lovely. And it's not actually that far from where we pulled in earlier. And there is a campsite up there where you can camp. And you can go fishing. And that's a nice little getaway as well, you know. But this will be spectacular when they have it completed. I could have sworn there was another, maybe it was a different place I was seeing on Facebook. Where there was like a wooden bridge or something.
I don't know.
Or a wooden, you know, walkway over the more marshy part. And identifying plants. In this kind of weather, this is just spectacular.
Yep, the flowers of bindweed.
Bindweed.
Very. Snotty little weed. Invasive.
Sure, what that is. I think it's an eagle.
Nope.
Look at the size of them.
Oh yeah. Beautiful.
Yeah. Alright.
So these are the bindweed, you can see, chokes off the plant by covering it all up. When it covers up all the seeds of the native grasses, the seeds can't spring out anymore.
Okay.
And it just climbs all over everything, choking it out. There's its little arrow-shaped leaves.
So if you see it, pull it, get rid of it.
You'll notice that it's far less prevalent where the trees are, and there isn't a whole lot of blackberry underneath the trees either.
Yeah. More plants, but that's why we're out here, you know.
Yorkshire fog? I don't think so. I think it's a blue. I think the fuzzy, these fuzzy ones right here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I think that's bluegrass.
Yeah.
As far as I can tell, it's bluegrass. It might be Texas bluegrass, but it looks like a bluegrass to me.
I don't think it's Yorkshire fog anyway, out here.
Yeah.
I mean, who knows, you know? Stranger things have happened.
I can see at least four different types of grasses out here.
Yeah.
Including what I think might be meadow sweet, which is used as an extremely expensive industrial oil.
Yeah.
A very good alternative to petroleum products.
Good start though, and it's a lovely stretch. Like if you wanted to come down and do laps, do pace walking laps.
Oh, very nice. I wish they had length posts.
Yeah, to show the distance.
But this, I mean, obviously the asphalt is new.
Yeah,
it's in great condition, and definitely seeing activity, deer activity, because I see their little poopies.
Oh, you'd get a lot of deer out here at night time, I'd say, when there's no one around.
Says apple. It's not an apple.
I'd say what you'd have to do is like be up close to the leaf so I can see the leaf.
Oh yeah, but at least the
possibly the bark.
At least the AI is getting information from me.
Yeah.
Because I submit all these pictures too.
Yeah.
Western cedar. There.
Western cedar.
With the flat leaves, and then they have little ball-like cones to them. They smell really nice when they cut.
Oh yeah.
That is definitely an alder.
Lovely. just lovely. It's just really spectacular out here.
Very warm.
Yeah, when it is hot like this, just remember to always bring water with you, plenty of water. Love those
right there.
Yeah, I love the color of them. Now that would make a spectacular bonsai.
Oh, absolutely. I don't know exactly what causes it to change color, but the early leaves are just beautiful.
They are.
Most fir trees that we see are farmed fir trees or Christmas trees.
Oh yeah. There, of course, is Ebonhawk.
Ah, there's the river.
There's the river, yeah.
Beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like it's in great shape too.
Yeah, it's a little bit upriver there. There is a campsite. You can camp for the night and do a bit of fishing and stuff. It would be really cool.
Concerning because it can kill a tree in no time.
Yeah, it can strangle them. Those almost look like redwoods, are they?
No. It has the same bark, doesn't it?
It has, yeah. The bark looks very similar. It's just a bark and it reminds me of a redwood. Nice, a couple of benches, a trash bin, keep the place nice and tidy. Yeah, this is lovely, it's just a little small picnic area.
Lovely
nice
little area.
Benches.
Sitting at one.
Yeah. There's a river just down there. lovely.
Looks like they do encourage
it. Like you're right in town too. It looks like they do encourage it, yeah. And like you're right in town. There's town right there. So if you need anything else, like if you've got anything, you can just run into a shop.
Salal bushes.
There's a hawk there, yeah.
So the crows are upset with the hawk.
Yeah.
And the crows are infighting among themselves.
Yeah. And the hawk said, I'm getting out of here.
Ornamental plume, I think.
There?
I think these might be ornamental plums.
Diverse
little place.
Oh yeah. And here we are. And that is that. A really, really nice walk. They are making fantastic progress on it.
Yep.
It's going to be amazing when they open up some more of it and you get down by the riverside and stuff like that. It's going to be lovely. That's really brilliant. Well worth trying. Oh yeah, there's the... We are back at Ebonhawk. Alright guys, thanks for watching and subscribing. If you like the video, please hit that subscribe button. And we'll be back with more in the not too distant future. We definitely have, I think now, three other ones lined up.
Yep.
There's the lighthouse one, there's Sunset Bay, the second, the longer trip out there.
Yeah, hopefully we can get to the actual big Silver Falls. That
yeah,
would be
so
lovely.
Just four, yeah, including that, there's four, and of course the pedal railway we're going to be doing as well. So we've got a lot of stuff up and coming. So it's
all the beautiful things of Oregon.
Exactly, yeah, that we want to show off. So have a good one, guys.
See you later.
Well, that was really something. That was, short, but a really pleasant walk. And you know, if you live in Coquille, you can easily come down here and do pace laps, come up here jogging.
Oh yeah, great.
It'd be
for
great
that.
Exercise, you know. And it's such a beautiful place too.
Thank you.
balloon opera house.
Cool.
Is that a stadium or something?
That is a big...
First Community. That's a big
building.
Branch. Because we bank at First Community Credit Union.
Thank you.
yeah, the Golden Falls takes about